Welcome back everyone, I'm Priya. I hope you all are safe at your places. So in my last videos, I taught you present tense, okay? All four subcategories of present tense. And now it's time for looking at simple past tense, okay? The first subcategory of past tense. So let's know about this. See, an action that is over is expressed in simple past tense, okay? The action which is done, okay? Which is not going on. So, that action is included in simple past tense. And here, these are the identities. It carries gaya, aaya, gayi, li, di, diya, ki, etc. Okay, it never carries hai or tha at the last of the sentences. Okay, please don't get confused. When there is hai, then like if there is diya hai, ki hai, di hai, li hai, okay. Hai is everywhere with these words, then it is not simple past tense, it is present perfect tense. Why? Because remember one thing, hai always represents present tense, okay? And when there is tha, with all of these words like gaya tha, aaya tha, gayi thi, li thi, di thi, diya tha, then it is always past perfect tense, okay? Not simple past. Okay, because this is properly, this shows like past tense, and if we are adding this with these words, it means that action is perfectly done, okay, in the past. So, let's know about the first rule for affirmative sentences here. It, subject always has to be there at the very first, okay, then verbs, second form, and then the object. Okay, so let's have an example here. Maine ek patra likha. Okay, so firstly, we always have to compare our sentence, English sentence, with this rule here. So, firstly, maine. For maine, we are going to put the first subject, I, then verbs, second form, wrote. Here, I have written ek patra, so a letter. Maine ek patra likha, I wrote a letter. I for the subject, wrote for the verb, second form. A letter is the objective part, okay? So, always compare your sentence with the rule, okay? While translating the sentences. So, now we are moving on to the another part, and that is negative sentences. So, all we have to do is we have to change the verb second form with the verb's first form, okay? And we have to put did not, or we can say didn't. So, firstly, as usual, subject plus didn't, did not or didn't. Didn't is the contracted form of did not, okay? Plus verb's first form plus object. Let's have an example here. Maine patra nahi likha. Okay, so firstly the subject, I, then didn't. We use didn't for every person. First, second, third, every person, okay? So, I didn't. Verb's first form, okay? Not second. So, I didn't write. Then, object. And object is patra only. So, I didn't write letter. Full stop. I didn't write letter. Let's talk about the interrogative part, okay? So, here the rule says, we have to put did first, then the subject, verb's first form, and then the object. Never forget the question mark. So, let's have an example here. Kya tumne patra likha? According to the rule, did, subject, tumne. Did you, verb's first form, likha, write, object, pat. Did you write letter? Question mark. Okay, and here, see, this is the question. If I'm going to answer this question, if I'm going to answer, did you write letter? Okay, then the answer will be yes or no. Then yes, I wrote the letter. Okay, or no, I didn't. Okay, so here, the answer is in yes or no. That's why we are using did at the very first, okay, instead of using WH. Because here, I'm not giving an explanation first. Firstly, I'm going to give the answer in yes or no. Okay, I hope this is clear. Now, let's then move to the explanation part where we have to explain the reason or the thing, whichever people or the person asked me. Okay, so WH family plus did plus subject. Plus verbs first form plus object plus question mark as well. So, tumne patra kise likha? Okay, now here the person who is asking me the question needs an explanation. Okay, that's why we are going to use this WH family. So, let's have a look here. Tumne patra kise likha? Okay, so kise, or kise we use whom? Okay, देयर सब्जेक्ट, तुमने यू वर्ब्स फर्स्ट फॉर्म राइट देन द ऑब्जेक्ट पत्र द लेटर क्वेश्चन मार्क ओके एंड हियर आई एम गोना गिव एन एक्सप्लेनेशन दैट यस आई रोट द लेटर टू माय मदर ओके सो दिस इज नॉट यस आई रोट द लेटर और नो आई डिडंट नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द अदर पार्ट एंड दैट इज इंटरोगेटिव नेगेटिव ओके सो हियर द रूल इज डिड प्लस सब्जेक्ट प्लस नॉट वर्ब्स फर्स्ट फॉर्म प्लस ऑब्जेक्ट प्लस क्वेश्चन मार्क ओके सो आई एम टेकिंग द सेम एग्जांपल फ्रॉम हियर तुमने पत्र किसने लिखा व्होम डिड यू राइट द लेटर फाइन सो फॉर दिस वन दिस सब्जेक्ट नॉट वर्ब्स फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑब्जेक्ट क्या तुमने पत्र नहीं लिखा ओके सो हियर आई विल बी लाइक डिड फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट सब्जेक्ट तुमने यू then not okay we have to put not after the subject part did you not then verbs first form write did you not write then the object the letter did you not write the letter so here there is a difference okay when there is not after the subject then and if the not is with the did with the helping verb there is a difference between these two rules okay when we are putting not after subject and when we are putting not with the did okay see it carries strong feelings here I ask the person here I ask the subject did you not write the letter it's okay I'm going to write the letter for you okay but here I'm angry I'm showing some strong feeling okay so I will be scolding the subject so firstly just translate it so didn't subject you verbs first form write then the object the letter question mark so here I'm angry okay because here that letter was a bit important okay and I believe that the subject will be doing that but he or she didn't so here I'm a bit angry and I'm like didn't you write the letter it was important okay so this is the difference please know this I hope today's topic is clear to all of you guys this is your homework that you'll have to make 10 sentences of each case of affirmative, negative, interrogative, negative as well, okay? 10 sentences each and submit it to me in the comment section or personally. So, I hope this topic is clear to all of you. We'll meet soon in my next video. Till then, please take care of you and your loved ones. Be safe and be at your places.